Dear nurses, for all state PSC, AIIMS, Railway, PGIMER, JIPMER, all government exams, please subscribe this channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. Thank you.
So, let's start. First question, the vaccine which is given as intramuscular injection, A. Measles vaccine, B. BCG, C. DT, D. OPV. The correct answer is C. DT. The vaccine which is given as intramuscular injection, correct answer is C. DT. Second question, the green stick type of fracture is common in which of the following group? A. Children, B. Elderly people, C. Women, D. Obese patients. Correct answer, A. Children. The green stick type of fracture is common in which of the following group? A. Children. Third question, venom of cobra attacks on A. Digestive system, B. Nervous system, C. Circulatory system, D. Respiratory system. The correct answer is B. Nervous system. Venom of cobra attacks on nervous system. Fourth question, puerperium is the period in a woman's life which is first weeks after her first menstruation, B. First 6 weeks after delivery, C. First 2 weeks after marriage, D. Period from conception to delivery. Correct answer is B. First 6 weeks after delivery. Puerperium is the period in a woman's life which is first 6 weeks after delivery. Following is not a staff under primary health center. A. Medical officer, B. Health worker female, C. Lab technician, D. CT scan technician. The correct answer is C. CT scan technician. CT scan technician is a not a staff under primary health center. CT scan technician is not a staff under primary health center. Sixth question, following is a disease spread through the urine of rats. A. Leptospirosis, B. Chikungunya, C. Malaria, D. Dengue fever. The correct answer is A. Leptospirosis. Following is a disease spread through the urine of rats. Leptospirosis. Which of the following statement about rice is false? A. Milled raw rice contains low amount of vitamin B. B. Husked raw rice is a poor source of calcium. C. Hand pounded undermilled rice is a fair source of B vitamins. D. Parboiling of rice causes loss of thiamine while milling. The correct answer is D. Parboiling of rice causes loss of thiamine while milling. Which of the following statement about rice is false? Parboiling of rice causes loss of thiamine while milling. The other three options about rice is true. Eighth question, at how many weeks of gestation uterus reaches the level of umbilicus? A. 32 weeks, B. 20 weeks, C. 22 weeks, D. 12 weeks. The correct answer is A. 32 weeks. At how many weeks of gestation uterus reaches the level of umbilicus? Correct answer is 32 weeks. Ninth question, MDT is a treatment approach for which disease? A. AIDS, B. Leprosy, C. Tuberculosis, D. Hepatitis. Correct answer is B. Leprosy. MDT is a treatment approach for which disease? Leprosy. Tenth question, Mission Indradhanush is a program related to A. Palliative care, B. Antenatal care, C. Immunization, D. Mental health. Correct answer is C. Immunization. Mission Indradhanush is a program related to immunization. That is the correct answer. 11th question, Pap smear is a simple test to predict the occurrence of DASH in females. A. Ovarian cancer, B. Breast cancer, C. Oral cancer. D. Cervical cancer. The correct answer is D. Cervical cancer. Pap smear is a simple test to predict the occurrence of cervical cancer in females. 12th question. The relationship of fetal head and limbs to its trunk is A. Attitude. B. Lie. C. Presentation. D. Polarity. The correct answer is A. Attitude. The relationship of fetal head and limb to its trunk is attitude. 13th question. Anganwadi's function under which central government program? A. BSS. C. ICDS. D. NMEP. D. NRHM. The correct answer is B. ICDS. Anganwadi's function under which central government program? ICDS. ICDS is the correct answer. 14th question. What is the management of postpartum hemorrhage? A. Give oxytocin drug. B. Start an IV infusion. D. C. Massage uterine fundus in circular motion. D. All the above. The correct answer is D. All the above. The management of postpartum hemorrhage include oxytocin, start IV infusion, massage uterine fundus in circular motion. So all the above is the correct answer. 15th question. Which of the following is a description of a third degree tear after delivery? A. 2 cm long tear on right mediolateral area of vagina after labor. B. A tear involving vaginal muscles. C. A tear involving anal sphincter. D. A tear extending into vaginal mucosa. The correct answer is C. A tear involving anal sphincter. Which of the following is a description of third degree tear after delivery? A tear involving anal sphincter is the correct answer. 16th question. A child doubles its birth weight at A. 6 months. B. 8 months. C. 10 months. D. 12 months. The correct answer is A. 6 months. A child doubles its birth weight at 6 months. 19th question. Phototherapy is used to treat A. Physiological jaundice. B. Anemia. C. Convulsion. D. Fever. Correct answer is physiological jaundice. Phototherapy is caused to treat physiological jaundice in newborns. 20th question. For a poor anemic woman, which of the following food may be added to her diet in plenty? A. Milk and curds. B. Green leafy vegetables. C. Fruits. D. Cucumber. Correct answer is B. Green leafy vegetables. For a poor anemic woman, which of the following foods may be added to her diet in plenty? Green leafy vegetables. We can add to her diet plenty of green leafy vegetables. 21st question. Kidneys are composed of millions of functional units called A. Neurons. B. Rod cells. C. Nephrons. D. Follicles. Correct answer is C. Nephrons. Kidneys are composed of millions of functional units called nephrons. 22nd question. Which day is observed as a World TB Day? A. October 30. B. September 29. C. February 14. D. March 24. Correct answer is D. March 24. So, March 24 is observed as a World TB Day. 23rd question. Dash is added to water to remove temporary hardness. A. Calcium hydroxide. B. Iron exchange resins. C. Sodium carbonate. D. Calcium carbonate. Correct answer is calcium hydroxide. Calcium hydroxide is added to water to remove temporary hardness. So calcium hydroxide is the correct answer. 24th question. Dash is the best spacing method for a woman who has one child. A. Copper T. B. Tubectomy. C. Oral pills. D. Vasectomy. Correct answer is copper T. Copper T is the best spacing method for a woman who has one child. 25th question. MDT Act came into force in India in the year A. 1971. B. 1948. C. 1986. D. 1969. Correct answer is A. 1971. MTP Act came into force in India in the year 1971. 26th question. Which of the following statements about the rights of children in India is false? A. Child has the right for physical, emotional and social development. B. A child's right to survival begins from birth. C. A child has the right to be protected against all sorts of abuse. D. A child has the right to participate in any decision directly involving himself. So please note the question. Rights of children in India is false. So B is the correct answer. A child's right to survival begins from birth. Other three options are true about children. Which of the following statements about the rights of children in India is false? A child's right to survival begins from birth. 27th question. The causative agent of diphtheria is A. Bordetella, B. Salmonella, C. Corynebacterium, D. Mycobacterium. The correct answer is C. Corynebacterium. The causative agents of diphtheria is Corynebacterium. 28th question. Obesity is defined as a body mass index A. more than 30, B. less than 18, C. between 25 to 29, D. from 20 to 25. Correct answer is more than 30. Obesity is defined as a body mass index more than 30. 29th question. AIDS is transmitted by A. bite of bed bugs, B. sitting on same bench with the patient, C. sexual contact with patient, D. shaking hands with a patient. Correct answer is C. sexual contact with a patient. AIDS is transmitted by sexual contact with a patient. 13th question. The incubation period of influenza is A. 1 to 2 days, B. 1 to 2 weeks, C. 15 to 20 days, D. 1 to 6 months. Correct answer is 1 to 2 days. A is the correct option. The incubation period of influenza is 1 to 2 days. 31st question. The following is a measure to control dengue fever epidemic in your locality. A. Washing hands before eating food, B. drinking oily only boiled water, C. remove collections of water from old tires, broken toys, etc. D. covering mouth and nose while in public places with a mask. Correct answer is C. remove all collections of water from old tires, broken toys, etc. The following is a measure to control dengue fever epidemic in your locality. Answer is remove all collections of water from old tires, broken toys, etc. 32nd question. The following is an advice given to an antenatal woman. A. Do not wear cotton garments. B. Do not eat fruits in early pregnancy. C. Do not take vitamin supplements. D. Do not take over-the-counter medicines. Correct answer is D. Do not take over-the-counter medicine. The following is an advice given to an antenatal woman. Do not take over-the-counter medicine. Which of the following is a true statement about the breastfeeding? A. Breastfeeding will not help in weight gain of a newborn baby. B. If a baby develops diarrhea, breastfeeding may be stopped temporarily. C. Breastfeeding should be started 2 hours after normal delivery. D. Breastfeeding promotes bonding between mother and baby. The correct answer is D. Breastfeeding promotes bonding between mother and baby. So the answer is true D. The statement about breastfeeding is true. Breastfeeding promotes bonding between mother and baby. 34th question. Meconium is a blood in urine. B. First stool of a newborn. C. Breast milk produced in the first few days after delivery. D. Discharge from uterus after delivery. Correct answer is B. First stool of a newborn. Meconium is a first stool of a newborn. Pentavalent vaccine will not protect a baby against the following disease. A. Hepatitis, B. Pertussis, C. Polio, D. Diphtheria. Correct answer is C. Polio. Pentavalent vaccine will not protect a baby against the following disease. Which disease? Polio. Polio is the correct answer. Sixth question. Ratio of cardiac compression to ventilation in giving basic life support for an adult is A. 15:2, B. 20:2, C. 30:2, D. 40:2. Correct answer is C. 30:2. Ratio of cardiac compression to ventilation in giving basic life support for an adult is 30:2. Correct answer is 30:2. 37th question. Oral pills should not be given to a woman with A. menstrual problems, B. hypertension, C. asthma, D. vaginal infection. Correct answer is B. hypertension. Oral pills should not be given to a woman with hypertension. 38th question. The expected date of delivery of a woman with LMB on January 20 is A. July 20, B. October 20, C. September 27, D. October 27. So, from the LMB, you should add 9 months plus 7 days and the answer is October 27. The expected delivery date of delivery of a woman with LMB January 20 is October 27. You should add LMB plus 9 months plus 7 days. The correct answer is October 27. 39th question. The process of developing and providing planned experience to a supply information changes attitude and influence behavior is A. health promotion, B. wellness, C. health education, D. coordinated school health. Correct answer is C. health education. The process of developing and providing planned experience to supply information, change attitudes and influence behavior is health education. 14th question. An android pelvis is one which has a kidney shaped brim, B. fifth lumbar vertebra fused to sacrum, C. hair shaped brim, D. ovoid brim. Correct answer is C. hair shaped brim. An android pelvis is one which has heart shaped brim. Thanks for watching, students. Please subscribe NerdSchool channel for more videos and don't forget to hit the bell icon. When you hit the bell icon, you will get immediate notification when I post a video. Thank you.